rising sophomore in the School of Biomedical Engineering at Drexel University, and I'm also part of the Pannoni Honors College here. At Drexel, I work with Dr. Balasubramanian, who is part of the School of Biomedical Engineering and Science and Health Systems. But I was also lucky enough to have the opportunity to be a part of this year's iSTAR cohort, which meant that I traveled to India for 10 weeks, and I worked in the Indian Institute of Technology in Madras at their biomedical engineering department. Overall, it was a great experience. I mean, the facilities they had there were amazing. The people were extremely friendly, always trying to help me like learn new things and get further in my work. So I thought that it was a great opportunity to go there, and it was a great experience being there. And there I worked under Dr. Ramakrishnan Swaminathan. I was working as part of the non-invasive imaging and diagnostics lab, which meant that they worked a lot with medical imaging, biomedical devices. And so I was trying to test whether you could tell the difference between pre-fatigue and post-fatigue conditions in a certain muscle group in your hand using this technique, using infrared imaging. But what I found overall was that the kurtosis, or in other words, the distribution of temperatures throughout the hand, changes very significantly between pre and post-fatigue. The end goal of a project like this would be to see whether you can monitor the development of injuries, to see whether you could pick up things like some hand disorders, some upper extremity disorders, so that before they develop into a major problem where you can't use your hand, you can catch them early and start treatment early. When I was going through high school, I realized that the kind of person I am, I'm always thinking in like a problem-solving kind of way. So that's what led me towards the engineering side. But also, I've always wanted to help improve the quality of life for people, whether that's in medicine or developing different kinds of machines or devices to track disorders. That's what led me to the biomedical aspect. So put those together, obviously you get biomedical engineering, and so that's what drew me to my major. And then specifically at Drexel, I know it's a great engineering school. They have great facilities for all kinds of engineering. We have the co-op program, which means that I get great opportunities to go directly into industry as a sophomore, as a pre-junior, and as a junior, and work in, whether it's a research institution or a hospital, I can work in any of those places and get great learning curves.